In today's video, we present part two of our Pulp Alley Halloween Special, Innsmouth Gold. In our last episode, the crew of the Triton snuck into the cursed village of Innsmouth, searching for the fabled Innsmouth Gold. With treasure in hand, they now seek to flee, before they are overwhelmed by the minions of Dagon. Will our band of seafaring adventurers escape with their ill-gotten gains? Find out today in the second half of our Pulp Alley Halloween special, Innsmouth Gold. Okay, welcome back everyone. Here we are at the top of turn four, and the first thing we do is draw for some new deep ones. And I draw a one and a two. So one more deep one pops up over here. And another two emerge from the ocean over here. Okay, so Captain Conniger and Bonnie Blades have temporarily cleaned the streets of deep ones, so some new ones have popped up near the idols there, but for the moment, they have a clear path to the boardwalk, so Captain Conniger is going to kind of move in that direction, but first he needs to draw a scenario card. And that card is From the Shadows. Place a denizen 1d8 inches from this character in a random direction. So a deep one pops out of the shadows. 1 inch that way. So I guess that's kind of like right here. But that's fine. I think Captain Conniger will just shoot it since it's 1 inch away. So he's shooting with 3d10. It does not get to dodge because it's a deep one, but it does resist its first health check. And he only got one success. So he shot, but he was not successful because it wasn't able to defeat the scaly armor of the deep one. So he shot. I think he's going to take off this way. Kind of run over here. Bringing his stolen idol with him, his ill-gotten goods. Okay, so that's Captain Conniger. He is a man on the run. Okay, well next up is Bonnie Blades, I guess. And she's going to have to draw a scenario card and roll for a horror check because she's within 12 inches of some of these deep ones here. All right, her scenario card, Quirk of Fate. It says, all other solo cards and effects currently in play are immediately canceled, discarded, without any other effect. This includes attached cards. All right. So there's a Quirk of Fate. Anything that was in play, and there wasn't much, is now gone. And she needs to roll her horror check. Come on, Bonnie. And she does not. So she needs to draw a horror card. Unbalanced. For the duration of this effect, this character is impaired. Okay, so this basically means if she tries to run, if she has a regular move over 6 inches, she needs to roll a health check, and if she fails it, then she drops one die level, which would basically knock her to the ground. But I don't think it says rushing here, so I think rushing is still different. So she's going to rush into combat regardless because that's not a regular move. That's the way I'm reading it anyway, and I stand by it. So Bonnie Blades may be unbalanced, but she's still going to rush into combat, so she's going to rush that deep one there. Combat steadies her nerves. So she is brawling with a 3d6, and the deep one is brawling with a 3d6. So it could go either way. And let's see, the deep one got no successes, and Bonnie Blades got one. However, the deep one is going to ignore that because of scales and such. So Bonnie Blades will be fighting this deep one during the deep one's turn because they're locked in combat. But they both fought once, so they'll be brawling at 2d6 instead of 3d6. So that's what's going on there. Okay, moving on to Lucky Bill and Long Gun Pete. We're going to draw a solo card for Lucky Bill. Foul Play. The closest enemy to this character encounters a peril immediately, which would be great, except that deep ones are immune to perils. So that is the solo card. Lucky Bill is not subject to horror from these deep ones, so that's pretty cool. So he is just going to shoot. He's not a very good shot, but it's close range, so he's shooting with 3d6. He gets three successes, so the deep one is going to ignore one of those and then have to roll two health checks. And he gets them both. Oh, that could have been great. So anyway, Lucky Bill shot and scored a pretty solid hit, but it wasn't enough to bring down this eldritch horror from the depths of the sea. But now we go to Long Gun Pete, and he's going to have to take a horror check because of all these fishmen closing in on him. But first we draw a solo card. Decoy, roll the challenge below. Pass, the scenario is extended by one turn, and fail, the character cannot run during this activation. So it is a two die might or finesse challenge, and as a level 2 ally, Long Gun Pete can't really pass that. He's only got 1D might and 1D finesse. So he's going to fail, which means he can't run this turn. So that's not that bad. He wasn't going to run anyway. So Long Gun Pete cannot run, but he can still shoot. So he is going to shoot at that deep one there. At close range, he is shooting with 4D6. And he gets two successes, which is enough to make the deep one take one health check. Come on! And he fails it. So Long Gun Pete takes out a deep one. So Long Gun Pete fires the musket and is able to dispatch one more deep one. Okay, but now it's the deep one's turn. So we'll start over here since that's where we are. So this deep one is going to go ahead and charge Lucky Bill because he's closest. The deep one attacks with 3d6 and Lucky Bill dodges with 4d8. And let's see, three successes for the deep one and only two successes for Lucky Bill. His luck may be running out, so he's going to have to take a one die health check. All right, Lucky Bill! And he passes it. So even though the deep one raked him with his claws, Lucky Bill wasn't really seriously injured, and chicks love scars anyway, so he's fine with that. So Lucky Bill is still standing. So in terms of this other deep one, it's pretty close. I measured it, and it's, you know, just a fraction of an inch either way. So I'm going to roll it. I'm going to roll 1, 2, 3 for Lucky Bill and 4, 5, 6 for Long Gun Pete. And Long Gun Pete. So this deep one is going to charge Long Gun Pete, who is going to have to take a horror check. So Long Gun Pete rolls for his horror check, and he fails it. So he draws a horror card. Run away! He moves 2d6 directly away from the closest horror immediately, and each time he activates, if he doesn't get rid of it. So rather than stand and shoot, and he would have had a pretty good opportunity to try to do defensive fire on that deep one, he's going to run. So he runs 8 away. So it doesn't say anything about running off the board, so for the sake of the narrative, we're going to keep Long Gun Pete in play. We're just going to have him run 8 inches while staying on the board. Another 2. So Long Gun Pete is running away from the deep one. He had enough of that action. He keeps shooting them, and they keep coming after him. So over here, I'm sure this deep one would like to be going after the idol holder, but he is currently locked in combat with Bonnie Blades. So they're both fighting with 2d6 because they've already fought this turn. And so the deep one got one success. Bonnie Blades got 2. And so the deep one is going to make her take one health check. And he's going to have to take one health check as well. All right, here we go. And the deep one succumbs to his injuries. And Bonnie Blades is fine. So way to go, Bonnie. So Bonnie Blades takes out another deep one. But now she has fought twice in this turn. So doing the measurements, this deep one here is in range to rush Bonnie Blades, so it is going to do so. And this other one is going to go after the idol bearer because he is not in range to rush Bonnie. So he will move. I'll just move him about 6 inches that way. So he knows there's something in the fog, but he's just going to kind of shamble that direction. So first things first, Bonnie Blades needs to make a horror check because she's been rushed by a fishman. And she does. She's getting pretty good at this. So she survives the horror check. But her brawl is just down to 1d6 because she's fought twice. So she's going to have to dodge instead. So she's dodging with 2d6 and the deep one is fighting with 3d6. The deep one got one success and Bonnie was not able to dodge it. So she needs to take a one die health check. And she fails. So poor Bonnie finally succumbs to the onslaught, and so she is knocked over. And she'll have to try to make a recovery check at the end of the turn. Okay, so that is all the deep ones. So this is the end of turn 4. Now we're going to roll some recovery checks. First, let's roll to see if Bonnie Blade recovers from her injury. And she does. So she's going to stand up. So she is going to stand up and continue fighting. She could actually step back an inch, but I think she's going to lock this deep one in combat. Now let's see if she can get rid of her card here, unbalanced. And she does not, she keeps it. And then Long Gun Pete over here, let's see if he can recover his wits and stop running away. See if he can get back into the fight. So 4, 5, or 6, and he does not. He's gonna continue to run away. All right, that is the end of turn 4. Now we go into turn 5. So Captain Conniger is running toward the boardwalk, hauling his stolen idol, and the Deep Ones will do their level best to stop him while eviscerating all of his crew members at the same time. So that is what's going on. So the one thing you don't want to have happen in a game is to have it grind on and on. So since this is running on a little bit longer than I had originally anticipated, we're going to remove a section of the boardwalk to shorten Captain Conniger's escape route. So we're going to remove this section, which would be about one turn's worth of movement. Also, in the scenario as written, the skiff would count as a plot point. So when the captain got down there, he would need to roll for a peril, you know, because the skiff is bobbing up and down in the water in the fog. And then after he succeeds with that, he's got to draw another challenge to see if he can actually get in the skiff. And so that would just bog down the game for another turn or two. And so we're not going to do that either. So if he can just get to the skiff, we're going to call that good. Okay, so the first thing we need to do at the top of turn five is draw some Deep Ones. So Lynn, you want to draw those cards?
Okay, you got two.
Two and?
One.
One, so a total of three. So that means two more Deep Ones spawn over here by Lucky Bill and Long Gun Pete. And another one spawns over here next to Captain Conniger and Bonnie Blades. See, Lynn, we're using those Reaper Deep Ones that you painted. And they're going to be gunning for Captain Conniger. So I guess with that in mind, let's start with Captain Conniger. So the first thing he has to do is draw a scenario card. Blocked. Draw a random challenge. This challenge is a peril. If he passes, there's no effect. If he fails, it's normal for the peril. So there is some sort of a fishing net or a crab trap or something like that that's blocking his way. And he barrels through it. But in the course of doing so, he draws a peril. Oh, this is a nice one. This says free pass. This challenge is passed.
Nice.
So, yeah. So this is a zero challenge challenge. So Captain Conniger is going to move his six. I'm going to take him up to right about there. Okay, so that is Captain Conniger. He has moved. He's not really in range to shoot anybody, though. So Lynn had asked if when the scenario card had prompted Captain Conniger to draw a challenge, which then might subject him to a peril, if he would be immune to that peril because of his hideous grace, and I suppose he probably would. So we went through that exercise probably for nothing, but the result is the same. Okay, next up is Lucky Bill, the first mate, and he is a loyal sidekick, and he is not subject to horror from the Deep Ones, but he does need to draw a solo card. Not so easy. The effect is the character suffers a one die penalty for all challenges. If you pass a challenge, transfer this card to the nearest enemy. So he got to attach this card to his character card, but since he's not really passing a lot of challenges, it may not come into play all that often. It doesn't affect shooting or fighting, which is good because Lucky Bill is currently entangled in a brawl with this Deep One. So the Deep One is going to attack him with 3d6, and Lucky Bill is going to dodge with his 4d8 and then try to escape once again. And let's see, so the Deep One got one success, but Lucky Bill dodged at least a couple times. So the Deep One whiffs with his claws, and Lucky Bill backs up an inch, because that's what he does. He's Lucky Bill. So he backs up. I guess that's his turn. So he fought, he dodged, he backed up, and that is Lucky Bill. Now we revisit the story of Long Gun Pete. So Long Gun Pete is currently running away. Now, I had some questions about how running away actually works, so I went straight to the top on the Pulp Alley Facebook page. And Dave Phipps, the author, said you roll your 2d6, you run away that distance, and then after that, you can make your move as normal. So if you have leftover movement after you run your 2d6, you can still move and then take an action or shoot, I guess. If in the course of running away, you bump into an obstacle or another player, you're supposed to take a peril check, but we didn't do that. So Long Gun Pete. He is going to run 2d6. So he's running 10 inches.
That's a long way. Well, he might get in range of that other Deep One, though.
Yeah, so this is kind of interesting. So Long Gun Pete is going to run a full 10 inches. So Long Gun Pete runs over here, and actually he can see Bonnie Blades fighting this other Deep One, but they're slightly out of range. And even if they weren't, Bonnie Blades is in close combat, so he couldn't shoot that Deep One anyway. And speaking of Bonnie Blade, she is locked in vicious hand-to-hand combat with this Deep One here. She was knocked down, but she recovered at the end of the turn. So she was injured, she shook it off, and now she's still fighting. So she will fight that Deep One. with 3d6 versus his 3d6. So it's actually pretty even, but Bonnie Blade seems to have luck on her side, so she's been pretty good about dispatching these deep ones. Let's see if that streak continues or if I just cursed her by saying it out loud. So Bonnie Blade's got one success, and the deep one got one success. Now, here's the thing. The deep one normally would be able to ignore a one-hit health check. So if she let that hit go through, he would ignore it anyway. But she's the attacker, so she can choose to use her five and block his five. So knowing that no damage is going through, she's going to prevent his damage from going through. So she does a deft parry with her dual sabers, and it is a standoff. So both those guys are still locked in combat. If it's not going to go through anyway, why take the hit?
Why take the hit, yeah.
So I think that's everyone in the landing party. Captain Conniger, Lucky Bill, Long Gun Pete, and Bonnie Blades. And they all made their moves. And so now we go to the deep ones. And things are about to get...
scaly.
Scaly. That's a good word for it. All right, so Captain Conniger, stuff is about to happen here because there's a lot of deep ones in range to rush him. This deep one can rush him. This deep one could rush him. So the deep ones are supposed to rush the character who's closest. And we did fudge that once for the sake of the story. But in this case, Captain Conniger is clearly closer to these two than Bonnie Blades. However, over on this side, clearly these two deep ones have a taste for Lucky Bill. So they want to rend him limb from limb because they're tired of his shenanigans. So this deep one is going to charge Lucky Bill. Lucky Bill is dodging, which fortunately for him does not deteriorate. 48 dodge for Lucky Bill and a 3d6 attack for the deep one. So the deep one got two successes and Lucky Bill got four successes. So he dodges away once again. So he moves back about an inch. This deep one here charges Lucky Bill. So the second one charges Lucky Bill. Same thing, 48 dodge, 3d6 attack. And again, he dodges away, an 8, a 6, only one success for the deep one. So he dodges back again, about an inch. Now we have to remeasure, because maybe he's moved far enough away that Captain Conniger is closer.
That would be unfortunate for Captain Conniger.
That would be. Damn you, Lucky Bill. So now this deep one is about 10 inches away, and this other one... about 11, and Captain Conniger, let's see. So yeah, it's pretty close with this one, so I think what we're going to do is we're going to have this deep one charge Captain Conniger, and this deep one will charge Lucky Bill. So that seems to be the will of Dagon at this point. So this deep one charges Lucky Bill. He kind of steamrollers around here, and he's going to teach Lucky Bill a few dance moves.
Swing your partner, do-si-do.
Claw his face off, don't you know? Here we go, 48 versus 3d6. And, three successes for the deep one, and only two successes for Lucky Bill. And actually, he can block one there, and block one there, so the deep one does succeed in getting an attack through. So Lucky Bill needs to make a health check.
Come on, Lucky Bill.
Come on, Lucky Bill. And he makes it.
All right.
So he once again dances away, drawing the deep ones after him. I don't know what his plan for escape is because Captain Conniger is going to be in the skiff and gone, and Lucky Bill is still going to be dancing with these deep ones. All right. So that is the saga of Lucky Bill. So Bonnie Blades is still fighting that deep one. They both fought once this turn, so they're both fighting with 2d6 now. And Bonnie got a 6. The deep one got nothing. He ignores the one hit. And so that's still a standoff. So everyone is locked in combat. So let's see. Long Gun Pete. Nobody has rushed Long Gun Pete, so he's fine for the moment. So now we go to Captain Conniger, and things are about to get salty. His fighting is pretty good. He's got a Blessing of Dagon, which helps him ignore health checks. He brawls with a 3d10, and he ignores multiple fight penalties. So he's a pretty good brawler. So this deep one is going to rush Captain Conniger, try to claw him back off the boardwalk with the precious idol. So, Captain Conniger is fighting a 3d10, and the deep one is fighting a 3d6. So, Captain Conniger got just one success, which the deep one will ignore. The deep one got two, And so Captain Conniger ignores one because of his hideous grace, but he's got to take a one die health check. And he makes it. So he gets clawed, he gets raked across the back, but he shrugs it off. Yeah, that's his Kevlar captain's coat that he picked up. And then on this side of the table, this deep one is going to rush Captain Conniger. So 3d10 versus 3d6 for the deep one. And Captain Conniger got 1, 10, and a 4. So the deep one got a 6 and a 4. And actually, because Captain Conniger is not the attacker, he can't block that. So this hit goes through, and this hit goes through, and then the deep one and Captain Conniger ignore the other hits because they ignore one die health checks. So each of them needs to make a health check. And Conniger got his, and the deep one failed his. So the deep one is dispatched. His scaly head is knocked from its scaly shoulders by the cutlass. So the deep one goes away. Which, oddly enough, makes room for another deep one. So this deep one chieftain is going to rush in, and he is going to attack, trying to knock Captain Conniger off the boardwalk. This deep one got a 5 and a 6. Captain Conniger had a 10, a 9, and a 9. So these will go away because they both ignore one die hits. So Captain Conniger needs to make one health check, and the deep one makes 2. And Captain Conniger fails his health check.
Oh, no.
And the deep one fails one of them. So this deep one goes away. It was a suicide attack. So Captain Conniger takes a hit. So he is slightly wounded in the calf. So I think that's all the deep ones for the moment. Now we can roll some recovery checks. So Captain Conniger is now down to D8s. He'll roll a D8 for his recovery. And he gets it. So he shrugs off that wound. I've had worse, he says. That's right. Slap a little seaweed on there and you're good to go. Let's try to cure Long Gun Pete of his runaway. And he does. So he's no longer running away. He's had time to recoup his courage. And then Bonnie Blades is still unbalanced. Let's try to recover that. And she does. So everybody is back to full fighting spirit. All right. Well, that is the exciting turn 5. Now we move on to turn 6. So here we are in turn 6, and the first thing we need to do is draw for some deep ones. A 2, of course it is. So 2 deep ones over here. All right, and another 2. So 2 more deep ones pop up over here, and things are about to get darn interesting. All right, so we start with Captain Conniger, and he starts by picking a scenario card, and it is, they're everywhere, of course it is. So, draw a random challenge. Place a new denizen 1d8 inches from this character in a random direction, or if he fails, place a new denizen in contact with this character. So this is a level 2 challenge for cunning. Captain Conniger has a cunning of 2d8. Will this be enough? He needs to get 2 4 pluses. And he does. So he gets 2 4 pluses. So that means a new denizen pops up, but it's not right on top of him. It's not in base to base. So rolling 1d8. And it's 3 inches, kind of that way. So, kind of about right there. A new friend that he didn't know he had. So I believe Captain Conniger is still in combat with this deep one here. So he's going to have to fight with 3d10 versus the deep one's 3d6. And let's see, the deep one got 2 successes. Conniger got 3. So the deep one and Conniger each ignore one health check, and Conniger could block this one. So maybe, well, let's see here. Yeah, he'll block this other one because he's the attacker. And so the deep one needs to make a one die health check, which it fails. So it is killed. And he gets to move his 1 inch, which isn't that far. Okay, so that's Captain Conniger. Now let's go to Lucky Bill. So first off, we have to get a solo card for Lucky Bill. Missing clue, roll the challenge below. Pass, this character gets a 1D bonus when rolling for any plot point. Fail, this character cannot run during this activation. So he needs to pass a 2 finesse or cunning challenge. His finesse and cunning are 3D8. And he does not do it, so he can't run. He can't run this turn. I was going to have him actually take off 12 inches to try to get away from these deep ones, but I guess he's sticking with them. He's twisted an ankle during his bobbing and weaving, so now he can't run this turn. So Lucky Bill is shooting with 3d6. Deep ones do not dodge. He got two successes. Deep one ignores one, so it rolls a one die health check, which it fails. Gets rid of this deep one here. Path. Nice job, Lucky Bill. So I think Long Gun Pete, now that he is free of his horror card effects, he's going to try to help out Captain Conniger. So he is going to move his full, well, maybe not his full 12. He'll move up within 6. So Long Gun Pete runs up to this deep one to try to help Captain Conniger. But once he gets close enough, he needs to take a horror check because now he sees how hideous they are. He remembers. So, rolling for his horror check. And he fails it, of course. Draws a horror card, which is run away. Again. So, he's going to run away. 8 inches. So that's 8. And if we play it according to the way Dave told us to play it, then he would run all the way back here and crash into the building and then have to take a peril. He thought he had his nerves under control, but I guess he didn't. So the challenge is a 2-die challenge for might or finesse. He's only got 1d6 of each, so he's going to make 2 health checks. This could be the end of Long Gun Pete. And, he's knocked down. He knocks himself out. So he runs into the building, knocks his head on the door. So he is down. We'll see if he recovers at the recovery phase. Next, we have Bonnie Blade. She is locked in combat with that deep one. So 3d6 versus 3d6. All right, here we go. So let's see. The deep one got 1 success. Bonnie Blade's got 3 successes. So the deep one is going to ignore 1. So she needs to make 1 health check, and the deep one needs to try to make 2. And the deep one makes both of his, and Bonnie Blade's fails hers. So her luck ran out. So poor Bonnie Blades is knocked to the ground once again. Will she recover in the recovery phase? We can hope. But for now, I think that is the end of the landing party phase, right? Everybody did their thing. Yeah. Now the deep ones are going to rampage. So after taking some scientifically precise measurements, this deep one here is going to rush Lucky Bill. This deep one here is going to move 6 inches toward the idol bearer. This deep one way over here is going to rush the captain. And these 3 deep ones here will move 6 inches toward the captain. So we can just do that now. Kind of like that. Kind of like that. And let's see. Kind of like that. And then this deep one moves over here. So it's a party on the boardwalk. And then all 3 of these are going to rush Lucky Bill. We'll start with this one way back here. So he rushes in at the limit of his rushing ability. Now, he could do defensive fire, but I think he's just going to dodge because that's his thing. So 3d6 versus 4d8. And Deep One got 1 success. And Lucky Bill dodged the heck out of it. So he moves back 1 inch. This Deep One charges in. Go, Bill, go. Dance as if your life depended on it.
Because it does.
Because it does. 2 successes for the deep one and 2 successes for Lucky Bill. So he dodged his way out of that one, too. He moves back 1 inch. And this other deep one charges in. And 2 successes for the deep one and 3 successes for Lucky Bill. So he backs up again about 1 inch. He better move on his next turn. He better run. So things are actually looking a little bit grim for the landing party. So Lucky Bill is back here in the corner, facing off against 3 deep ones. And over here, Bonnie Blades and Long Gun Pete are both lying in the street. And hopefully they'll recover on the recovery phase. But now we go to the battle with Captain Conniger. And so this deep one here, with all of his buddies kind of approaching from both sides, rushes Captain Conniger so he can rescue the golden idol. So it's a brawl of 3d6 versus 3d10. And Conniger got a 10 and a 6. And the deep one got a 6 and a 4. So Conniger ignores 1 wound. And the deep one ignores one wound, and so they both need to make a one die health check. So everybody passed a health check. So they are locked in combat. This guy is just kind of holding on to Conagher's ankle so they can drag him to the briny deep. So that is the end of the turn there. So I guess we need to roll for some recoveries. So let's roll for Bonnie Blades. And she recovers.
Yay.
And then for Long Gun Pete. And he does not. So Bonnie Blades stands up. She was just playing dead. And Long Gun Pete does not. He was not playing dead. He got concussed by running into that door. And then he got hypothermia in the fog. So that is the end of Long Gun Pete. Okay, so that is the end of turn six. Now we move to turn seven. All right, well, here we are at the top of turn seven. We've had so many turns in this game. We've gone to two dice to mark the number of turns. So I'm starting to feel like Cecil B. DeMille here. This was supposed to be a short, maybe 90-minute, two-hour shoot. And now we're on day four. So we're going to wrap it up today. Come hell or high water. So whatever happens, we need to wrap it up today because we got to get this thing edited before Halloween. So here we are, turn seven. And Captain Conagher is running, or he's trying to run, toward the skiff. So he has the idol in tow. He's making a run for it. And the rest of his crew members are trying to buy him some time, though Long Gun Pete is gone. They don't know what happened to Long Gun Pete. He actually ran into a door, bonked his head, and so he is down and out. Maybe he'll come back in another scenario, but for now, he is no longer part of the crew. Well, maybe he found a pub or a chowder house or something like that. He's having a bowl of gumbo. All right, so turn seven. So I guess the first thing we do is draw for some deep ones. So that's one and two. Okay, so one deep one emerges from the ocean over here. That's one of the brine shrimps. And two deep ones pop up over here. Another crustacean and a froggy deep one. But frankly, the last thing Lucky Bill needs is more deep ones because he's already got three of them on his case over here. And his compatriot, Long Gun Pete, is nowhere to be found. So Lucky Bill is all by himself in this corner of the game. And over here in the center of the board is Bonnie Blades. She's been fighting up a storm. She's been knocked down several times, but she's still in play. So hopefully she'll be able to contribute to decimating some deep ones here in turn seven. So as I said earlier, we have shortened the distance to the skiff just to speed things along. But even so, I think Captain Conagher is going to have his hands full because there's deep ones all over the place within rushing range. So we will activate him first. We're going to draw a scenario card. And his scenario card is Alone in the Dark. Draw a random challenge. If he passes, there's no effect. If he fails, draw a horror card for this character immediately. So right on the cusp of victory, Captain Conagher could be hobbled by some kind of psychological effect. So this is a level 2 challenge for finesse or cunning. Captain Conagher has 2d8 finesse and 2d8 cunning. So he needs 2 4s or he's going to be hobbled by a horror card. 6 and 6. So he's fine. He got 4 or better. So he's okay for the moment. And let's see. I guess he has a deep one right on his tail there. And so he's going to need to fight that deep one. So fortunately, Conagher is a pretty good brawler. He's going to be brawling with 3d10 and the deep one is fighting with 3d6. The deep one got a 6 and a 5. Conagher got a 6 and a 4. So as he is the attacker, he could actually block this 6. He can block out that one attack. This one would go through, and this 4 he rolled would go through. But then he and the deep one would both ignore that, since he and the deep one ignore single die health checks. But he needs to break free from this combat. So maybe instead what we'll do is he'll just let everything go through. So he will take a risk, let everything go through, and then both he and the deep one have to roll a single die health check. So Conagher is taking a risk here. He's going to roll a d10 for his health check, and the deep one is rolling a d6. And, oh boy, the deep one passed, and Conagher failed, so Conagher takes an injury. So I think that was a reasonable gambit, because he wanted to win combat, kill that deep one, and then keep running, but it didn't work out that way. So he takes an injury, so he's down to d8s. But you know, actually, he has a ability called Indomitable, which allows him to reroll a health check once per turn. So we're going to use his special ability and see if he can reroll that and get a 4+. And he does. So because he is indomitable, he rerolled his health check once per turn and he succeeded. So so he didn't take an injury. So as I understand the rules, if Conniger had not taken a hit, then he could disengage. He did take a hit, even though he used his indomitable skill to reroll the health check. Okay, over here, Lucky Bill is still bobbing and weaving, though he's a little bit outnumbered. His partner, Long Gun Pete, is nowhere to be found, and there's more deep ones on the way. So let's see what happens for Lucky Bill. But first we draw a solo card. Hesitation. This character cannot perform any actions and cannot run until the end of the turn. That might not have been a bad idea to have him take off and run, actually, since he's not currently engaged. So maybe he can move his six, but he can't run, which is kind of unfortunate. He is, however, still in range to shoot that deep one. Yeah, Bill, see if you can apply that luck to some fancy shooting. So Lucky Bill is going to shoot with 3d6 because he's at close range. And the deep one does not get to dodge, though he does have his blubbery defense. So 3d6. And one success, which the deep one ignores because of his resistance. Okay, Bonnie Blades. Now, frankly, if she was a normal seafaring adventurer at this point, she would say to heck with this and run off the board because there's deep ones all over the place. However, that's not Bonnie's style, so instead she's going to attack that wall of deep ones. But first she needs to draw a solo card. On fire. This is pretty good. So the effect is that a character gains +1 brawl and +1 shoot each time any character clearly wins a fight. And then you transfer this card to that character. All right, well, that's good. So if Bonnie wins a fight, she's going to get a buff on her next fight. So we will attach that to Bonnie's card for now. Though if Lucky Bill or Captain Conniger win a fight, then they're going to get the card. So she's going to rush that deep one there. Time to pull out her filleting knives, is that what you said?
Yeah.
That's right. So, okay, so Bonnie is fighting with 3d6. That deep one is fighting with 3d6. So if she wins this fight, though, she gets to use that card for a bonus on her next fight, which she might need because her fighting skill is going to decline with every fight. So, let's see, the deep one got one success. Bonnie got one success. The deep one is going to ignore his, so Bonnie should just use her 4 to block it, so that it is a standoff. So she was not successful, but she didn't have to take a health check either. Not a great round for the crew. They're brawling for all they're worth and firing pistol shots, but they're not really succeeding in taking out too many of these deep ones. And frankly, I only have one deep one left in reserve. So currently on the board, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's 11 deep ones on the board and only 3 crew. This could be their swan song during the deep one phase. So Conniger does not suffer from multiple fight penalties, but these deep ones do. So that deep one fought. Bonnie Blades fought. This deep one fought. And then Lucky Bill fired his pistol. So all the crew members have fought at least once. So Conniger and this deep one are going to fight. We'll start here. And then the rest of these deep ones are going to rush to their respective places, and the crew is going to find themselves quickly overwhelmed, I guess. So the deep one is attacking with 2d6, and Conniger is fighting with 4d10 because he doesn't suffer from multiple fight penalties, which is handy at this point. So the deep one got 2 successes, and Conniger got 3. The deep one is going to ignore 1. Conniger gets to ignore 1 health check as well, so it is 1 health check for Conniger, 2 health checks for the deep one. I think we got that straight. So Conniger failed. He got a 1. So Conniger failed his health check. He already did his reroll at the beginning of the turn when he fought the first time, and the deep one passed both of his. So the deep one injures Captain Conniger. So Conniger is injured. He's down from D10s to D8s on some of his most important attributes. And the deep one fought twice. So that is 1 wily deep one. Okay, so I tried to figure out a way to justify having 2 deep ones on the walkway, but there's just no way to really make that work. And there's no rules in the scenario for them swimming in the water, So I guess they will just pile up behind Conninger. So there's a deep one there. There's a deep one there. All right. So I guess these other deep ones are probably going to rush Bonnie Blades. But first you'll have to fight this deep one she's already fighting, because now it's his combat phase. So both of them are fighting with 2d6, I guess. And let's see, Bonnie got 2 successes. The deep one got 1. So that goes away. This success goes away because of the deep one's natural resistance. So each of the combatants needs to roll a single die health check. And Bonnie got hers. The deep one failed his, which is good because that is a clear victory. So now she gets to use this combat card. So even though she's fought twice, she will get a slight buff from that card on fire because she is currently on fire.
Yay!
Yay! So Bonnie has fought twice. This deep one goes away. So we're going to say this deep one is going to charge Bonnie. And he's going to attack with 3d6. And she gets to attack with 2d6 because of her buff. Okay, here we go. So let's see, the deep one got no successes and Bonnie got 1 success, but the deep one is just going to absorb that. So no hits go through on that attack. So now Bonnie has fought 3 times, but it doesn't really matter because she can't go lower than a 1d6 and she gets her buff from her card. So 2d6 is as low as she's going to go. This deep one charges Bonnie. It is a battle royale near the boardwalk. 3d6 for the deep one, and 2d6 for Bonnie Blades. So, the deep one got 2 successes. Bonnie got 1, which the deep one is going to ignore. So, Bonnie will need to take 2 health checks. Okay, Bonnie, here we go. And she fails both of them, and she collapses in a heap. So, the deep ones finally take down Bonnie Blades, though perhaps she will recover on the recovery phase. So these two deep ones are too far away to rush Lucky Bill, so they are going to move 6 inches toward the idol bearer. Put him about right there. And this guy goes about right there. So they're taking a little stroll on the boardwalk. So the deep ones have figured out that Conninger is heading to the skiff, and they definitely don't want that to happen. So they're going to try to bring him down any way possible. And Conninger will have to fight the good fight if he's going to get out of here with that cursed gold. And he'll probably have to abandon his compatriots, which is kind of sad. This was about the best crew that a captain could ask for, and currently they're in deep trouble. But maybe he'll go back to the ship for reinforcements. Okay, Lucky Bill, your time has come here, so you're going to get rushed by this deep one. I think you're supposed to take the most direct path, but for the sake of the narrative, we're going to make room for everybody so Lucky Bill can have a heroic last stand. Okay, Lucky Bill dodging with 4d8, and the deep one is fighting with 3d6. Deep one got 1 success, and Lucky Bill did dodge it. He got an 8 on his dodge, so he dodged 1. Lucky Bill is going to disengage 1 inch in case that helps him, so he's not in combat with all 3 of these guys. So this deep one will rush in. Same dealio, 4d8 dodge, 3d6 brawl. And Lucky Bill dodged again. Deep one got no successes. So Lucky Bill, well, let's see. I guess. How would he do that? He will kind of break away this way. And this deep one will charge in. Okay, Lucky Bill, dance for all you're worth. The deep ones are thinking, he can't dance if we pull his legs off. So, deep one got 2 successes, and Lucky Bill dodged them both. He's got a 7 and a 5, which is sufficient to dodge and to break away again, but he's kind of boxed in here a little bit. So, Lucky Bill kind of backs up. So, Lucky Bill has survived the deep one onslaught, but he's kind of in a bad situation there. Not where you want to be. He's running out of room to dance. That's it for the deep ones. Now we're in the recovery phase. Okay, let's start with Bonnie Blades. 4, 5, or 6 to recover. Give this one a good shake. And she does not. Oh, so sad. So that is the end of Bonnie Blades. Yeah, hopefully she is playing dead and then sneaking off to the chowder house to to get some gumbo, but she is currently off the board, so those deep ones finally brought her down. But she took out quite a number of them, so hopefully the deep ones, when they go back to their underwater temple, will remember the ferocious story of Bonnie Blades. Okay, Captain Conniger needs to recover from his injury, so he is rolling a d8 for his health check. Come on, Captain. And he does not. He maintains his injury. And Lucky Bill has no injuries. He's still on his feet, bobbing and weaving, so he doesn't have to make any recovery checks. So now we go to turn 8. And what will happen on turn 8? We're running out of crew members, that's for sure. So rather than drawing for deep ones, I'm just going to deploy the last two miniatures we have. That would make a round dozen on the table. So one deep one goes right there. And one deep one goes right there. So all the deep ones from the nearby Deep One Temple are currently in the town of Innsmouth. They're having a surface party. So let's see what happens to Captain Conniger from the shadows. Moving shadows alert you to a familiar presence. Place a denizen 1d8 inches from this character in a random direction. So let's see here. 8. So that would be kind of this way. So we're going to make a special case. So in this scenario, there's no real mechanism for the deep ones traveling through the water, but we're going to have a super deep one emerge right here. He is the extra special sumo deep one who has now emerged, and we're going to let him walk through the water just because we ran out of regular deep ones, and why not? So he is the extra buff deep one, so he can wade through the water, which might make Conniger's life a little difficult, but that's okay. So Conniger, I guess, is going to have to fight this deep one here. He's now fighting with D8s. So the deep one is fighting with 3d6, and Conniger is brawling with 4d8. So the deep one got one success, which Conniger is going to ignore. Conniger got two successes, one of which the deep one is going to ignore. So the deep one needs to make a one die health check, which he fails. So Conniger does defeat one deep one. Okay, so Lynn had asked about this on fire card. So Bonnie went away, but the card is still here. It doesn't say anything about discarding it. So it will move to Conniger. I think that's fair. Since we are going to saddlebag Conniger with the giant sumo deep one, we can at least give him the on fire buff. So Conniger will take his wound marker and his idol with him. He will back up 1 inch. And so that is Conniger's turn. So the only one we have left is Lucky Bill. Not feeling so lucky right now. So Lucky Bill, I guess he needs to draw a solo card. Watchful Eye. Roll the challenge below. If the character passes, he gets a +1 bonus when rolling for apparel. If he fails, he cannot move during this activation. It is a level 2 challenge for cunning or might. And actually, Lucky Bill has this card attached to his character card. Not so easy, so -1 die for any challenges. So that would reduce his cunning to 3d6. So he's going to roll 3d6, and he needs to get two successes, or he can't move. And he only got one, so a Lucky Bill cannot move. So Lucky Bill finds he can't move this turn because of a confluence of situations, and so he is going to wheel on his heels and shoot that deep one. So he's shooting with 3d6. And he gets two successes. So the deep one absorbs one hit, but he needs to make a one die health check for the other, and he fails. And so this deep one is dispatched. So that's the end of the crew's turn. Now the deep ones get to go. Since we're here, we'll just have these deep ones kind of charge Lucky Bill. So, brawling and dodging. Two successes. This is not good. So Lucky Bill, that's a 1, that's a 1, that's a 3. He only got one success, so he could dodge this one, but he's going to have to take a 1 die health check. All right, Lucky Bill. A 1. So he takes an injury. So this could be the beginning of the end for Lucky Bill. He takes a minor injury, which is slowing him down. And so, okay. Then I guess this other deep one is going to charge in. So Lucky Bill has been slowed down somewhat, so he is dodging with 4d6s. And the deep one is brawling with 3d6s. And let's see. Still more than enough to dodge the attack. So Lucky Bill dodges. So Lucky Bill dodges the attack, and he backs up 1 inch. this deep one is ducking under a pistol shot. He is going to go ahead and charge Conniger. So normally Conniger would fight at 3d10. He's injured, so now it's 3d8, but he has a buff card. So Conniger is fighting with 4d8, and the deep one is fighting with 3d6. So let's see. Conniger got three successes. The deep one got two successes. So deep one is going to ignore one, and Conniger is going to ignore one. So the deep one is making two health checks, and Conniger is making one health check. So Conniger failed a health check, the deep one failed a health check, and fortunately this turn, it's a new turn, so Conniger can re-roll that, but the deep one is gone because he failed one of his health checks, so he's out of here. Conniger will re-roll this one for his one and only re-roll, and he makes it. And since he won his fight, we'll give him 1 inch of movement, so he moves to the staircase. Okay, Conniger, there's deep ones all over the place. So this deep one rushes Conniger. So again, he's fighting with 4d8 because he's injured, but he has a buff card. And the deep one is fighting with 3d6. So the deep one got two successes. Conniger got two successes. So Conniger ignores one. The deep one ignores one. And they each have to make a health check. Here we go. And the deep one fails, but Conniger succeeds. So the deep one goes away.
And he gets to move his inch.
And he gets to move his inch. That's the way we're playing it. So he moves ever closer to the boat. Okay, so let's see. There's deep ones all over the place here. Yeah, definitely. So this one charges Conniger. So Conniger is fighting for his life on the walkway, trying to reach the skiff. So the deep one got three successes. Conniger only got one, which the deep one is going to ignore. So Conniger needs to make two health checks, because he ignores one. All right, Conniger. And he fails one, so he takes an injury. That is his second injury. So he didn't win that combat, and the deep one is still there. And just when Conniger thinks he's inside of the boat, a giant purple denizen emerges from the waves.
Hopefully the abomination has some seaweed in his eyes, so he swings wildly, especially since Conniger is down to D6s now.
Okay, so the abomination is fighting with 3d6s, and Conniger is defending with 4. So, let's see, the big purple guy got two successes. Conniger got one, which the deep one is going to ignore. Conniger ignores one, so Conniger needs to make a one die health check. This could be it.
This could be it.
And he makes it.
That's a good thing.
He makes his health check. So he makes it, but he's still locked in combat with two deep ones. Okay, now there's extra deep ones who are just going to shamble. So this deep one is going to move his 6. This deep one is going to move 6. All these deep ones are going to move 6. Everybody moves 6. And that deep one goes about there. All right, now we go to the recovery phase. Captain Conniger can attempt to recover one wound. And he does. So he's back from D6s to D8s. And now we go to turn 9. So now turn 9. And let's see, draw for some deep ones. 2 and 3. So 5 more deep ones pop onto the board. We don't even have that many. All you're going to get is 2 and 2, because that's all we have left at the temple. So one there, and one there, and one there, and one there. And this is officially our longest shoot ever by about a factor of 4. Well, maybe at least a factor of 2. But certainly much longer than anything else we've ever shot, and I'm not quite sure why. But anyway, here we are, turn 9. More deep ones on the board. I think that's a full 12. And I guess we can start with Lucky Bill, huh? So just for the heck of it, we're going to start with Lucky Bill. He's going to draw a solo card and move along. No effects, a free pass. So he doesn't have any bad effects from that solo card.
That's awesome.
So that's good.
Now he can run like the wind.
Run like the wind, Lucky Bill. If he can put another 12 inches between himself and these deep ones, they will stop chasing him and just shambled toward the captain. So Lucky Bill decided he's done enough for this endeavor, so he is going to run 12. So he's temporarily in the clear, and we forgot to try to recover his wound on the recovery phase. So we'll do that now. He's down to D6s, and he recovers. So retroactively, he recovers from that wound. So it is a good day all around for Lucky Bill. So where the heck are we? Okay, so that's Lucky Bill. Captain Conniger. Okay, well, Captain Conniger, I hope he clearly outlined all the risks and benefits on this mission for his crew before they embarked on the skiff. But anyway, he is here. He is currently engaged with not one, but two monstrosities. And I think now that he's starting engaged in with both of them, he needs to split his combat dice, if I remember correctly. So he is going to have to fight both of them, which is not going to be that great for him. And he needs to draw a scenario card. So the card is blocked, which says that the captain has to draw a random challenge, and this challenge is a peril, but because he has that cursed idol, he passes all perils. So something good came out of it anyway. So Captain Conniger has to fight both those guys simultaneously. He has to split his combat dice. Normally he has a brawl of 3d10. That's now down to d8s because of his injury, but he gets an extra die because of his card, because of his on fire card. So he's got to split those dice, so 2d8s for the blue guy, I guess. And he got two successes. The deep one got one, which the captain's going to ignore. So the deep one has to roll one health check. Here we go. And he passes, so he's still with us. Now the big purple dude, the purple people eater. And Conniger got one success. He got that 8. And the deep one got one success. But they both ignore single die health checks. So everyone is still locked in combat. So it is a furious brawl there on the walkway. Okay, now it's the deep one's turn. So we will start with the big combat here. So those two deep ones are attacking Captain Conniger. They have fought once. He needs to split his attack dice. So each of them will be fighting with 2d6, and he will be basically defending with 2d8. So the deep one got, this is the blue guy, got two successes. Conniger got one, which the deep one is going to ignore. So Conniger ignores one, the deep one ignores one, and so Conniger needs to roll a one die health check. And he got it, so he's okay. And the other deep one attacks. And he got one success, which Conniger is going to ignore. And then Conniger got two successes, one of which the deep one will ignore. So the deep one has to roll a one die health check, which he fails. So that's the big purple guy. So Conniger takes out the big purple monstrosity.
Yay!
Yay! It's a victory.
So does he get to do his 1 inch?
Sure, we'll give him his 1 inch. Why not? So Conniger moves back an inch.
And no one else can attack him because the other guys are in the way.
That's right. Yeah, so Conniger might be able to make it to the boat. So the rest of these deep ones are just going to pile in. They're going to line up on the boardwalk, chasing after Captain Conniger. They're tearing up the boardwalk in their zeal to get to Captain Conniger. That guy goes there. This deep one goes about there. Here's one here. Deep ones everywhere. So there's deep ones all over the place, chasing after Captain Conniger. Lucky Bill is going to slink off and try to find some grog. All right, Conniger, I think you've stirred up a hornet's nest here. And so let's see, recovery check, I guess. So Conniger will attempt to recover from his injury, and he does. So he's back to D10s. That was a close one, Conniger. So, okay, go to turn 10. Okay, we're not going to draw for any new deep ones because they're all on the table already. However, Conniger does need to draw a scenario card. They're everywhere. That's a scenario card. Draw a random challenge. Place a new denizen 1d8 inches from this character in a random direction, unless he fails the challenge, in which case it is right next to the character. So, okay. So it is a level 2 challenge for cunning or might. Captain Conniger has a might of 3d10. So this would be a good one to pass, because otherwise he will be adjacent to another denizen. And he does. He gets an 8, a 10, and a 5, so he passes it with flying colors. So let's see. How far away is that denizen then? 1d8 inches away, 7 kind of this way. So it's about kind of like that, about 7 inches. So a deep one pops up out of the water right there, another big purple guy. So it's Conniger's turn, and frankly, there is nothing stopping him at this point from running to the boat. He runs over here, he tosses the idol into the skiff, hops into the boat. Now, in a normal game of Pulp Alley, you would then have to treat the boat as a peril, and once you pass that peril, then you'd have to do another challenge to try to achieve the objective, but we're not going to grind it out. I think we've grounded out enough. So the captain gets into the skiff, he slashes the line with his cutlass, and takes off toward the sloop. Fortunately for the captain, the idol can be used as a 50 horsepower Evinrude, so he takes off, and he does wonder, whatever happened to Long Gun Pete and Lucky Bill and Bonnie Blades? And they're probably fine. They're probably okay. I'll meet him back at the sloop. And I guess fortunately for the captain, all the deep ones have left the underwater temple, so they're not going to be clambering into his boat. They're here on the shore where they're a little bit more cumbersome, so they can't really move as quickly. So they're out on the dock having a party, even the big purple one, and the captain is sailing away with his ill-gotten gains. And hopefully Bonnie Blades and Long Gun Pete and Lucky Bill are somewhere sharing a barrel of grog and some nice New England chowder, because they didn't make it to the skiff, obviously. So hopefully they will find their way back to the sloop. Maybe there'll be a rendezvous down the coast and they'll pick him up. But for now, Captain Conniger, that wily devil, has escaped into the night with his golden idol, his stolen cursed gold, and I hope it makes him very happy. I hope it fulfills all his hopes and dreams and doesn't descend all of humanity into chaos and madness. But you never know.
I'm just looking at all the deep ones.
Yeah, look at all those deep ones. There's froggy deep ones and crustacean deep ones and even a giant purple deep one. So
how far does the beacon go from the idol? Will they follow it to the sloop?
You know, I don't know. There could be, and actually because we do have a sailing ship, perhaps there will be a sequel where the pirates are on the sloop and all the deep ones are kind of piling on board trying to recover the idol. But that is a tale for another day. Okay, folks, that's a wrap on our massive Pulp Alley Halloween special, Deep Ones versus Pirates, fighting for that cursed Innsmouth gold. So we hope you enjoyed it. Thanks, as always, for stopping by. Take care of yourselves, and we'll see you soon.
See you soon.